down today. Just gonna take it nice and easy on the way down. Test out the new tines with the EDFC. They feel fantastic. They really do feel good. You can feel the operated springs just control the roll unbelievably well in comparison with the OEM stuff. You can really lean on it now. Whereas before, you felt the car wash out and was unable to control the body roll. Lovely sweepers. That's fantastic. Just pitch it in, let it glide out. So much visibility up here as well. It makes the whole thing great.
Yesterday in the dry, it was so good on a medium. You know, the adjustment's 16 clicks from soft to hard, and on an 8 all round, it felt amazing. Today, I wanted it full soft because the conditions are mental. A few storms have rolled in, and oh, it's horrid, horrid weather. Again, the ADO8Rs just look after me so well. And the suspension, being able to adjust it, again, just makes it so much more of an enjoyable car. The dampers seem to have really reduced roll, massively so. I mean, the spring rates are so much higher than going to. But what it has done, which I didn't expect it to do, balance the car up. It's balanced the car up so well. It feels transformed. It feels like the car it should have always been. You know, I feel like the OEM stuff's great for most people, and I'm not saying I'm anything special, but I know you can relate with what I like to do with my cars, because I'm sure a lot of you out there, if you're watching this, like to do similar. And with the roll now in check, you know, you can really, really make it dance about, and you can really feel, and that's what we want. We want that feel, don't we? We want to know what it's going to do before it bloody goes and does it. We don't want to be having a spirited drive and feel disconnected. We want that instant connection, and this has really given me what I wanted. I'm not saying that it's because I got time on a spot. Go out and buy some Maestro R's, go out and buy some BC, it doesn't matter, it just stopped the roll. The only thing I really wanted was that easy adjustability, because they're quite hard to get to actually change the damper settings. I know you can get extensions, but there's no way I can lean back there. I'd have to pull over every 5 minutes if I wanted to change them, but I can't be arsed with that. This car I've built for a purpose, and it was about £250 for the EDFC, and I think it's worth every penny for me. Other than that, the EBC pads, now I've used them a fair bit on a few track days, they've lasted well, and they are lasting well. They've still got about 60 to 70% of the life left, and yeah, it's done a few track days, especially Blighton, which is very hard on brakes, and doing well. They're okay, they're not brilliant, the initial bite just isn't there. But what is good is they're consistently okay. They are not okay, and then after a 10-minute stint, they degrade to being shit. They're just always okay. I've really struggled to get them to fade properly, which is amazing, especially when I'm pedaling it around in the wet and having to really lean on them. Not so much as any difference in pedal feel, but that did come as well from removing the VDC. Moved to VDC, and that gave me back a proper pedal feel. Didn't feel interfered with in any way. And I know the VDC shouldn't interfere with the brake pedal. It's also disconnected the ABS, and I don't want that. I want the ABS back. But it has got rid of all the bullshit, I tell you. Really, really can't wait till Nürburgring. I've spent far too much prep in this car now. But at the end of the day, look at it and look how it performs, the noises it makes, the consistency of it. What is it, about £10,000 build now? That's brilliant. I think it genuinely is the best car I've ever owned as an all-rounder. It's a Nissan, so I'm well aware it's going to let me down. Sorry for anyone who loves Nissans. I've had a few, I love them too, but they're going to let you down. I hope I have a fantastic time at Nürburgring. I'm going for quite a long time this time, and I just hope everything goes well. Last year in the MX-5 it was like a damn Top Gear challenge, you know, without the backup or support crew. It was just scary. The car left me stranded. And I had to push it down the hill to try and get on the ferry, and somehow managed to cough it back into life after dumping 6 litres of water Coral had made me take with me all over the engine bay, steam going bloody everywhere. Everyone else has already got on the boat at this point, put their bags in their rooms, and is now sat with their beers on the top deck watching this poor stupid lad in an MX-5. Struggle like hell, but we got on, we got home somehow. So this was the main reason I built this car. It's a Nürburgring toy, but you try and build a car like this for 10 grand with a Porsche badge, it's not gonna happen. And I know it's not as good as a Porsche, before I get flamed for talking bullshit, but is it 3 times as bad as a Porsche? because it's probably a third of the cost.